Thank you, Bart. Meet number two of our Friday Night Heights doubleheader on the way. Another top 10 showdown between the 8th-ranked Arkansas Gymbacks and number 9 Auburn here in Fayetteville. Last week, the Hogs beat Alabama on the road in Tuscaloosa, a first for the program. Tonight, they want to build on that momentum.
It was a big step forward for the Gymbacks, being able to step in and perform when it counted, which helped them mature as a team. Yes, Alabama fell 3 times on the beam and opened the door, but Arkansas still had to deliver. Not letting the pressure of a win get to them, they sealed the deal on floor and beam, and both Amanda Wellick and Samantha Nelson finished the beam with career highs.
Auburn might be a young team, but they have certainly skyrocketed into the upper echelon of the SEC under Jeff Graba and company. Alongside my partners, Courtney Kupetz-Carter and Casey Smith, I'm Alyssa Lee. Happy to be here with you tonight as we take a look at the Arkansas vault lineup. They are the home team and will vault first tonight. Everybody in this lineup scored a 9-8 or better on the road at Alabama last week.
And Leah is really great leadoff. She's consistent and really is able to find those landings. Slight hop this week. Just didn't have the block off that table in the direction she needed.
Auburn on bar so far this season. It's been their best event, ranked 7th nationally. Got great difficulty throughout the lineup, and you'll see quite a few stuck landings as well. Kelsey Kopeck will get him started, the redshirt junior. Jeff Graba put her in the leadoff spot because he wanted somebody with experience there who wasn't a freshman. This is an Auburn team with 6 freshmen and 6 sophomores, a lot of youngsters.
She's not a freshman, but also she never started on the bar, so she's a little reluctant at first, but she's beginning to embrace the role to lead this team off.
Had a great routine in the Florida meet last week. Was rewarded with a 9.825. Let's see what she does here tonight.
Few short handstands in this routine. Just the dismount left. A double layout. Wow. And a great landing. You could see her momentum kind of moving forward a little bit, so it wasn't a secured landing.
Good start for both teams so far. Here are the rules for college gymnastics. 6 gymnasts compete per event. Only 5 scores count, so coaches will drop the lowest of those 6 scores. At the end of the rotation, in the 4th rotation, the team with the highest running total will win the meet. Paige Zizinski ready to vault now for Arkansas. Made the right corrections last week at Alabama. Got the amplitude she was looking for. Almost got the stick. Picked up her highest score of the season with a 9.875.
Her body position in the air really sells this ball. So get that speed onto the table. Was a little behind. Off the table for that twist. You can see she's a little disappointed. Wasn't quite as good as last week.
Arkansas trying to maximize their full potential on vault. Just stick a few more landings here tonight. Pick up some of those scores and see those improvements Mark Cook is looking for. As you see Taylor Krickner, a freshman from Cypress, Texas. Now, she was sick last week, but did a nice job working through her 3 events on bars, vault, and beam. She's got some really nice difficulty in this routine, has a huge release move that you will see coming up, and is really just a beautiful bar worker. Judges just finished up scoring, so she's having to wait just a little bit. You know how much gymnasts love that, Courtney Kubetz.
Oh, you love it a lot. No, you really don't. You're set. You're ready to go. You're waiting for that judge. You're trying to go through that routine in your head again sometimes, visualizing the routine, starting your whole preparation over again usually.
Just one of those 6 freshmen on the road. You're really first true road test in the SEC, and energy was a big topic of discussion. Jeff Graba had not liked the energy so far this season. Chemistry still building for this team, but he wants to see them in their bubble and having fun.
And it's hard on bars to build that energy, but they really have to do it with having a clean routine from one girl to the next. Finally, that hit handstand there. Having a little trouble adjusting to the bars today. In dismount, she looked like she peeled off that bar a little bit. Wasn't quite able to release before she twisted. That brought her back into the bar just a little bit, but she held on to that. Grape is saying that was a great routine. Liking the start so far on bars. Free speed now, the sophomore. From San Antonio out of Olympia Hills Gym. She had a large hop last week. On vault, on the road at Alabama, scored a 9-7. Looking to clean that up here tonight. She was looking for a little bit more rise, some height off that table. She really did it. Just needed to get the landing.
Send it to the third member of our crew, Casey Smith.
Well, Melissa, you guys were talking about how the emphasis for Auburn has been the energy, and Jeff Graba told us that while he is watching the routines, he's also standing back and watching the huddle, really paying attention to the collective energy of the girls. He wants to see them as a group, and that dynamic continue to get better. And I'll tell you what, so far down here on the floor, these girls have a lot of energy. They're singing, they're dancing, they're cheering them on, and I know that's what their head coach wants it for.
Yeah, they were doing that before the meet, actually, as well. We saw them dancing, getting down, having fun. And again, it's a learning process when you've got so many youngsters on a team.
When you can be lighthearted and just get a little bit relaxed, your gymnastics seems to just flow better. You get in the zone. You're not forcing it.
Another freshman here, Emma Engler from Raleigh, North Carolina.
A little close on that release. You could see her arms bend when she caught it. And this was a routine last week where she didn't hit that first handstand and wasn't able to adjust. Every element afterward just was a little bit not to perfection. Tonight was definitely a better routine, and that landing, that is what will get your energy up when you can start sticking landings like that.
Now, the big correction for her was to not land low like she did last week. No problems here today. Chest up high.
Double layout, legs together, and chest was in a great position.
So far for Auburn, at a 9.75 and a 9.8. We see the freshman, Sydney McGlone. Got the height last week on vault, just did not stick the landing. Didn't get the block she needed. But this Yurchenko full for her, has hit for a 9.875 twice this season, so she can get it.
She's looking for that 9.9 if she sticks. Quickness into the board, onto the table, and that's what brings her that great height. Just not the stick for today.
So far on vault, a 9.75, 9.825, and brace speed with a 9.75.
And
as we look
bars,
at that point of emphasis here.
You are looking for those clean lines. Ideally, each performs with clean lines without any body breaks and a good flow. When you have that flow from one skill to the next, it really helps connect the routine.
Take a look at Kate Cruz, the senior from Michigan. Jeff Graba very happy with her bar set in the Florida meet. She did stick the landing, scored a 9.85. But she missed some training in the fall with a stomach virus. And we'll get more into that as to what's been keeping this team back a little later in the broadcast.
You can't tell so far by this bar team. She has great technique. Her handstands have been there. She has such a fluid swing. She makes it look easy. Is a little bit short on that last handstand. Double layout. I love her form. Here's her release again. You see her hips above the bar when she catches. That is the ideal release move. Then into this dismount. Watch how her legs stay together. And boom, she got it.
Beautiful. And she's following up the 9.875, which is a career high for Emma Engler. That should be a big score for Kate Cruz as we see Amanda Wellick, the All-American, very reliable all-arounder for the Hogs, has been dynamite on vault this season with 3.99 scores and 4 meets.
Wow. She has such great awareness. She has the balance of what you're looking for in vault, the height, the distance. But more than that, she looks for that landing, and she gets it. I think that's her third week now in a row she has stuck that landing.
I'm expecting another 9.9, if not better, for her. She's just got such awareness on that landing. It is uncanny for the junior.
Now, again, they can't get a 10, so the highest score she can get is a 9.95.
Correct. And that is with the devaluation of the Yurchenko full this year with a 9.95 start value, as we see Abby Millay, the sophomore from Texas. Very impressive bar set coming up here. Has been on point with the handstands this season, and she can also stick the dismount.
A nice release move there. Clean form throughout this routine. You see that extension through the shoulders as she continues to swing. Not much to that so far from this routine.
Wow! Whoa!
That was a clean bar routine, and she knows it. There is not much the judges can take.
Now, she hasn't scored anything less than a 9-8 on this event, and that's going to be a big score for Auburn as well. By the way, Amanda Wellick, we said she was going to get a 9-9, right? The judges agree. She got a 9-9 for that vault. Samantha Nelson now will round them out in this first rotation for the Hogs. She landed a bit offside last week at Alabama, sort of rushed it a bit. This will just be the third meet for her in the competitive vault lineup this season. We'll see what she can do with this Yurchenko full.
See, she still twists right off that table. Her shoulders turn before her entire body is up in the air. She's improved a lot from last year, but still just a little bit early off of the table as she turns. But finishes it well.
Mark Cook really likes how aggressive his team has been this year. He liked how aggressive they were on floor and beam last week to beat Alabama. And speaking of aggressive, Caitlin Atkinson, she flies on her dismount. It's awesome.
They say she usually sticks it every time, but that's the last skill you're looking for. She needs to make sure she focuses on each skill before that and only thinks about the dismount right as it comes. And even then, not the landing. She gets that release.
Whoa.
And the landing will be there a little off tonight. But still, they have performed well on the bars.
When you get up that high, it's hard not to stick it or come close to sticking it.
She had the height. Looked like she turned a little bit early as her hands were still on that high bar. She wants to release before that turn to solidify that stuck landing.
Oh, both teams off and running with some pretty good scores here in rotation one. Friday Night Heights on the SEC ESPN Network continues when we come back.
Let's get after it, okay, on three, Jim back strong. One, two, three,
Jim back strong!
Sorry, guys.
Building on stuff, all right? Let's get over there. It's going to be a good rotation over there. First one hit, let's just keep popping, all right? Let's go.
That first rotation was a good one for Jeff Graben. Auburn, as they have the lead here, the score 49-25 to Arkansas's 49-075. On vault for Arkansas, some pretty good scores, capped off with a 9-9 by Amanda Wellick. That was the big score there for the Gymbacks. For Auburn, a couple of 9-8-7-5s, that was the difference for them. They are off and running to a very good start here on the road. And with that, we welcome you to the competition floor. I'm Melissa Lee. She is Courtney Kupetz-Carter, and Auburn is coming off one of their best seasons, a 2015 campaign that saw them get to the Super Six for the first time since 1993. Huge expectations this year because of it, and they're having a little bit of a hard time dealing with it.
You name it, Auburn is going through it right now. They're trying to maintain several different injuries. They have a very young team performing about 10 new routines this year. And the upperclassmen are feeling the pressure to repeat the success from last year.
And you see the roster breakdown: 6 freshmen, 6 sophomores, just the 3 seniors on this team. But one of those seniors, the leader, Caitlin Atkinson, will show us what she can do on vault. And the Hogs, Paige Zizinski, is ready to go sky high with her bar routine. Rotation 2 up for grabs next. ESPN Network. We've got a full afternoon of women's college basketball. 1 Eastern, it's the number 12 Kentucky Wildcats taking on the Florida Gators. Then at 3 Eastern, Alabama squares off against number 19 Tennessee. Finally at 5 Eastern, number 22 Missouri battles Ole Miss. All of those games also streaming live on Watch ESPN. Well, Auburn is on top of Arkansas here in Fayetteville as we get set for rotation number 2. And it's a great opportunity to bring in the 3rd member of our crew, Casey Smith.
Melissa, you can't talk about Auburn very long before mentioning Caitlin Atkinson. She's off to a great start tonight, and last March against Alabama, she set the school record for the highest all-around score, and Jeff Graben said that even with that record, she's still not satisfied. She knows she wasn't perfect, and she's a gymnast who really pays attention to those scores and numbers and keeps striving to be perfect. Courtney, what does that say about her as a competitor?
It's amazing. I hope she really did let it soak in for a minute, though, because that is such a good all-around score. But look, she's a gymnast. She's pursuing that perfection, and she knows every little thing she does wrong, and she wants to improve it the next day.
Well, last time these two teams met, Auburn broke the 197 mark, and that was the all-around score for her in that meet, a 39.45, which was a career high or a school record, I should say, at that time. Now, she will anchor the vault lineup for the Tigers here tonight. The only one who will do a 1.5 with a 10-0 start value. The rest of the lineup will throw out your Chenkel Fools that have actually been scoring pretty well.
They really have been trying to distinguish. The judges have been trying to distinguish between the Yurchenko Fools that you see. They want to see that height and power.
Sure.
Over those 1.5, which is now the 10.0.
They've got a freshman that will lead them off, and Taylor Krippner from Cypress, Texas. And Jeff Graba told us she was technically not supposed to be in the vault lineup as a freshman. They wanted to wait, work on some of her consistency issues, but they didn't really have much of a choice. Now she's capable of throwing a beautiful, big Yurchenko full, and she's just got to go for it. She can get a little ahead of herself.
I don't think she got ahead of herself there. She really did use that table to get the block off the horse. And what I liked about this vault is her form in the air. There's the block, maybe a little bit early with the shoulders, but just keeps that body together, and that really helps that there was no bend in her hips.
And remember, Jeff Graba with a smile on his face, it's baby steps for these freshmen. Now Arkansas will move over to bars. This is the event this season that they really have struggled. They struggled on the road last week at Alabama. Mark Cook said they were tentative with the handstands, and it really did show in the scoring.
They just weren't aggressive enough. He wants them to attack these routines.
This is Kira Glover, the senior from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, to lead him off.
So far, a good swing. Just that giant pull into a double back dismount. And she grabs that lane. You could see her fight with it. When you have a stick in the first athlete up, you really hope it just becomes contagious for the rest of the team.
And she got up there really high. You see the difference between the Yurchenko Fools and the devaluation from a year ago, from a 10-0 start value to a 9.95.
That's right. And that's just for more variety. You're looking for the higher difficulty to be rewarded.
Sure.
When they do it.
Emma Engler now. Be competing in a handful of meets since her junior and senior seasons in high school, looking for an extra rep to get better. Not bad.
She definitely got that height in there, but she's a little close to the vault, so that will be a slight deduction when it's too close on that landing. You can see again, she just is continuing the twist when she passes that table. She really wants to finish the twist above the table to find that landing.
And working on not shuffling the feet. Every shuffle is gonna cost you.
That's right. It's a deduction per step, not one for the overall.
Stephanie Canizzaro was a little short on her handstands last week at Alabama. Did a nice job on the landing, had a little bit of a small hop. But when you're on the road, Courtney, you have to really get acclimated to the equipment in somebody else's backyard. They're at home, they know these bars, right?
That's right. You only get the warm-up to acclimate when you're at a weigh meet. They compete here at least 4 to 5 times in a year. They know what they're doing. Nice release, but you can see she came in a little bit close to the bar, had to bend those arms, and right there she had to do a half pirouette. Two of them, not part of the routine. Saved it, though, didn't have the fall, and found that landing. So it wasn't quite her best routine. There will be a slight deduction, but she held on. She didn't let falling over on that handstand. She was starting to arch. She didn't let that take her off the bar. She decided to cover and add a few elements and found that landing.
This is a Miracle Phillips, the freshman from Enterprise, Alabama. She's capable of vaulting out the building that has almost zero control on the landing right now. Jeff Graves says the vault is so big that they actually have to go out to the parking lot to grab her and bring her back inside. She struggles a little bit with the adrenaline in meets.
That's right. She gets to the meets and she's so excited and ready to go. She already has enough power. Oh, there you can see she had the speed. Looks like she might have injured herself on that landing.
She's got that leg wrapped, and that right leg looks like it might have been the problem as she came down.
She did have a very low landing. You could see her body was completely in front of her with that foot all the way behind her. A lot of pressure going to that feet. That's why you always want your chest up when you land. Less pressure on those feet. Take a look at that vault. The entry looks good. Looks a little high. Didn't get quite the pop she wants. Turned a little early. And there, oof, you could just see.
And now, Arkansas.
Closer look. Just didn't get the height that we talked about she usually has. She usually has a lot more height than that, so she probably wasn't ready to have a landing. If not.
She's being tended to right now by the athletic trainers as we see Erin Fryer, who will continue the meet over on bars for Arkansas. She had her chest down a bit on the landing last week. Her handstands, though, on point, and on point here tonight.
They are, both of those handstands. Beautifully hit, all the way vertical. You can see the push out in the shoulders. Great swing. And nailed that landing. There you go.
Come on. Come on. Bring it home. Come on, Erin.
Coach Cook liking what he sees on this bar routine.
He said, bring it home. She brought it home.
She really did.
That'll be a big score for the senior from Michigan. And on the other side, over on Bald, Miracle Phillips is still down.
You just hope it's not something serious.
Well, the second she got up or tried to get up, she didn't put any weight whatsoever on that right foot. They're tending to her, her right foot right now. It's the right leg that appears to be problematic. She has the left leg taped up, as you can see there, and she's got a doctor.
It could have been a matter of her left foot hurting, putting more pressure on her right foot, kind of balancing that out. You can see the Arkansas doctor there tending to her on the mat. They need to make sure, before they pick her up, they need to be safe and careful. I need to ask her several questions before they move her off that mat.
So they are going to help her off right now. Will not put any weight on that leg whatsoever. And they've got a stretcher waiting for her around the corner to take her to a hospital and get evaluated.
And there you even see the assistant coach helping her as she goes out.
So the vault score so far for Auburn, the 9-7 by the freshman Krippner, the 9-7-7-5 by Engler. Phillips, the score will go down as a 9-2-7-5. So one Auburn will drop. But more importantly, it's how will this team respond with their freshman teammate down and out. They don't know her condition right now.
It's difficult, but she does have to perform here. Lexis Demers nails the landing. But you still think back, and it's difficult to see your teammate going out. But this is a gymnastics meet. It keeps going. This team has to rally behind and do this for her now. You can see the block off the table and the form in the air again. This is technically correct. She had it all tight, and that's what helped her stick that landing.
Over to bars and Amanda Wellick. Now, this event has been problematic for her this season. Send it over to Casey.
Melissa, last week, Arkansas's emphasis, after they struggled on bars versus Alabama, was not paying attention to the score moving forward. And that's exactly what you see Mark Cook telling these girls down here. Stay aggressive. Stay in the moment. Lots of smiles down here so far.
Now, Wellick has had a problem getting the proper pressure on her hands on this dismount. Coming up, has sat it down the last two times we've seen her in the Georgia meet and at Alabama.
And that move she did right before it, they switched right into that double front. She, like you said, she has sat it down a couple times, wasn't able to get the release and the angle she needed to stand on her feet. It's a blind landing. It's difficult. And there's the release move right beforehand. Set her up for that double front, chest up in the air.
Yeah. Much better, much better.
Much better for sure. She's been waiting to do that. They wanted to get in the gym, have a little bit more practice, right. And it looks like changing that last element before the dismount helped her out.
As MJ wrote, the junior from Minnesota. And she's going to pass the table. She'll have a chance to come back and try it again.
That's right. As long as she does not touch that board, she has the opportunity to go back and vault again. Could have gotten her steps off, maybe started with the wrong foot. You do take the same number of steps every time when you're vaulting into that hurdle. Just a little bit off.
One of the things Coach Graba told us was sometimes these gymnasts get in their own heads a little too much. That's been a little problematic for this team this year. And for her, she's just tried too hard to stick. Gets in her own way sometimes. Tries to go out there and get a 10 every night. He said, you've got your Yurchenko full. You can't get a 10. The best you can do is a 9.95, so just go get it.
There she goes. She got it this time. Oh. In the landing.
Whoa.
She needed to get out of her own head, and I think that run by really did it for her.
That was big time.
There you go, off the table, huge block in the air, great distance, and she finally got the stick she was looking for.
Oh, she's going to be happy with that score when it comes in. Brave Speed now on bars for Arkansas following the 9.85, a season high for Amanda Wellick as she fixed that dismount and that landing. Speed averages a 9.806 on bars this season. Very steady.
Great height in that last release move. Really a great swing to this bar routine.
And remember, Courtney, she was a little crooked winding up for the dismount last week.
That's right. This giant pull, she does out of that toe. See, she's a little crooked again, and that really messes up her tap, but she adjusted and got that landing.
Literally making the adjustment midair and that's on the landing.
That's exactly what the coaches are trying to help you to do. If you make a mistake, you fix it in the middle of your skill. There's one handstand. You can see a little bit of an arch in the back. And a little bit crooked there, but still, she was able to tap, get enough height into that double back dismount.
Yeah!
And grab that landing.
Yeah!
Mark Cook loving this. Bar set from his team here tonight. And on the other side, Caitlin Atkinson will follow up the career-high 9.9 for MJ Rote, the anchor for the Tigers on vault.
And this will be a 1.5 vault. You'll see an extra half twist. It's worth a 10.0. Great form. She's been doing this vault. She did it last year. She had a large step last week, and I think she improved on her step. It's a little bit smaller. Great height. Finishing it off.
She's had some foot problems dating back to last season in the Super 6 that still kind of bother her now. And so that Yurchenko 1.5 is actually not as hard on her body as the Yurchenko full.
As you can see, when you land short on those Yurchenko fulls, it really grabs those ankles. So she's right. The 1.5 would be a lot easier on the ankle, just not the stick.
And rounding out bars for Arkansas is Paige Zaziski, the sophomore. Got good technique, very precise. But you know what? Mark Cook noticed the judging summaries that she was not giving deductions in her amplitude, and so they were working on that this week.
And the amplitude came from a transition. Oh, she fought for that handstand. The amplitude came right from the skill she was actually going to do from the low bar to the high bar is where she made a change. She had a lot of swing coming into that shoot over onto that low bar, and if she used what she used to do was kind of jump up to the high bar, where the swing would have been helpful, but this time when she changed it, she just does a little circle around that low bar. It's like it just kind of messed her up.
Well, in terms of the scoring on bars for Arkansas, they can afford to drop this routine. The lowest they've got so far is the 9.7 by Cannizzaro. Everything else is a 9.8 or better.
And Paige is usually that gymnast that really can come in with that 9.9. Disappointing tonight, but finishes it with her dismount. It's very important to finish your routine.
So a good start for both of these two teams through these first two rotations. But again, the injury for Auburn, it's on their minds right now. We'll send it over to Casey, who is standing by with Jeff Graba.
Coach, you talked about how important the group dynamic was. You did have an injury on that last rotation. How did you see them respond?
Well, I thought they did a really good job. I like the fact that the girls got themselves together and got themselves situated. And you know, I thought we responded really well. It's unfortunate that we're, you know, dealing with an injured girl right now. But, you know, the meet doesn't stop, so we've got to keep going, and I'm happy so far.
And moving forward, what do you want to see on the next few events?
Well, we just got to continue to put that behind us, keep our energy level up, and stay focused. We're doing pretty well so far, but we've got to build on that.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
So far, so good here at the halfway point. We will break down the first two rotations when we come back. But first, follow the story of Ivy and Zach. Back here in Fayetteville, Arkansas, second meet of our Friday Night Heights doubleheader, and it is Auburn still on top of number 8 Arkansas here by a score of 98-275 to Auburn's 98-1, and both teams dead even with a 49-025 after the second rotation. Those were the two scores we saw. MJ Rode on vault with a big 9-9 for the Tigers. Arkansas, Brace Speed with a 9-8-5.
Amanda Wellick on the bars did great, but on the vault she did fantastic, a 9.9, sticking that landing. And what I love is the balance of height and distance. MJ Rod also on the vault. Yurchenko full nails it after running by the vault. Really helped her to relax, I think.
Second time was the charm. We're getting to the best part. Four and beam on the way. Amanda Wellick looking to build on her career high beam score from a week ago. And the Tigers' MJ Rode will put on a show on floor. Don't go anywhere. The Randall Tyson Track and Field Center will be happening tomorrow, 1:30 Eastern on the SEC ESPN Network. We'll have the Razorback Invitational, one of the premier indoor track and field events, and attracts some of the top schools and athletes in the country. It's also streaming live on Watch ESPN. And you know, Fayetteville is known as the track capital of the world. And when you've won as many national titles as Arkansas has in the sport, 41 on the men's side, one for the women, that title is legit and the facility top-notch, one of many phenomenal facilities on campus here. Go big or go home, right, Casey Smith?
That definitely seems like it's the motto around here in Fayetteville, Melissa. Mark Cook said that Arkansas truly is the total package. They have the academics, they have those top-notch facilities, like you mentioned, and that these student athletes know they're going to be taken care of when they get on campus. The newest addition is absolutely gorgeous. It's the Jerry and Jean Jones Student Athlete Success Center. It's complete with a nutrition center, with tutoring, with training tables, so much more. I'm telling you, if I was an athlete here, I would never leave that building.
It's pretty phenomenal. Mark Cook, of course, has been there every step of the way, has helped build the gymnastics program from the ground up. He says 10 years ago, they weren't quite up to snuff with the rest of the conference, but now he feels like everything they've got on campus gives him a leg up in recruiting, also allows his current athletes an opportunity to excel and succeed. His team has been very aggressive on beam this season. Pretty aggressive here tonight. They knocked it out of the park on beam on the road at Alabama. Saw some season and career highs because of it. And they've got their best beam workers at the top of the lineup. See Dillard, Zaziski, and Wellick. And Sydney Dillard will get them started, the senior from Fairview, Texas. Excellent in the leadoff spot on beam, averaging a 9.856. And again, Mark Cook, going back to look at the judges' summaries, noticed that the judges felt she could be more artistic and that her rhythm could be better, so they made some of those changes this week in practice.
She definitely sets the tone on beam, and since that change they made, it has helped everyone else kind of settle into place, know their position, know when it's time for them to get up. Slight wobble there. She really does set the tone for this team.
Mark Cook front loads the beam lineup with the consistent gymnast early to set the tone for the rest of the lineup, and so far it has worked for this team.
No movement on that landing. That's really what you're looking for on the beam, to hit every element precise. Any wobble or movement will cost you a small deduction or a large one, depending on the size.
He's named the team's most consistent performer in 2014 and 2015. That's someone you want on beam, right, to lead off?
It's a different position for someone to be that talented in that leadoff role, but it's such an important role. It's actually one of the most difficult lineup positions in the entire meet. 1.5 dismount off the end, straight in line, no steps. Just a small wobble on that first by canceling the out series, and then into this side element. It's required. great landing and the finish it off with her dismount. She's really able to find those landings well now on those dismounts.
Auburn will be on floor now. And Lucia Scaglione will lead him off. Send it over to Casey.
Melissa, Lucia has an extra special thing in her floor routine. Jeff Graba said they added a wink into it because they wanted to see more flash from her. They wanted her to get more into the crowd and get more energy. And she will wink during this routine. And Coach Graba said it's supposed to be directed towards him, but she has a little bit of struggle winking, and I totally understand that because I do too. So it'll be fun to watch down here.
I do too, actually. What about you, Cordy? Well, you're good at everything, so never mind.
I got the wink down, but I will say it is nice that they're giving her something to really perform with. It just takes something silly sometimes to get these athletes out of their shells. She's got the tumbling down, although this pass right here, the double bag, apparently she's definitely afraid of it.
Not tonight.
Didn't look like it to me.
This is a gymnast who actually quit the sport not thinking there'd be a place for her at the collegiate level. Graba picked her up, and she spent 2 years trying to get into this floor lineup.
It's amazing, and I do see her smiling, which is another element of performance you're looking for on that floor routine. And that's a long time to not think you're ever going to do gymnastics again.
Which is why this Tiger team gets pumped up when she gets in that lineup. And she is there tonight and looking pretty good.
Slight little hop back on that landing. You could see her teammates, though, on the side, raring to go. They're excited to see her compete. And when they're that excited, it really does set the tone for the rest of the lineup.
This is a team still without their freshman who went down on vault, the Miracle Phillips, but they bounced back nicely.
There is the double back that she's afraid of so much, and she just wills herself through it, they said. She just wants to compete that bad. And finishing off with that front one and a half, you could see she didn't quite find that landing, but was able to stand it up.
Floor has been a sore spot for Auburn this year, trying to put it all together. Six up, six down here tonight. We'll see what they do as we see Paige Zaziski struggled on bars here today. See what she can do on beam. It's her favorite event, and she's very calm when she's up there.
Could see her breathe right before that leap. She started off, had a little bit of a jitter, you could tell. This team just needs to calm down. Nice backhandspin layout her series. Last week they were able to take the pressure of not wanting to fall because they knew they were so close to winning. This week, they just have those jitters again for a different reason, but it's the same thing. Anytime you feel that nervous pressure, you have to put it toward your beam routine in a positive way, really aggressive, and attack your skills.
They're down 0.175 to the Tigers heading into this third rotation, so trying to chip away at that lead.
See a slight pause between that connection. You really need to make sure when you have two elements connected, there can be no pause. You can have movement through to the next skill, but a pause will be a deduction and possibly no bonus. But finishes that routine. She's excited, does a little dance pose there. They really do, first off, just need to stay on that balance beam.
Well, Casey Smith has an update on a Miracle Phillips. Casey.
Melissa, I'm being told that America Phillips is still in the arena with the athletic training staff. They are evaluating her, but they will be taking her to the hospital. I'll update as soon as I know more.
Thank you. That is good to hear. She's still being tended to and evaluated. Would like to know, obviously. Hopefully we can get that information by the end of the meet, how she's doing exactly.
That's right. This is Colin Lawick. She actually does her first tumbling pass last week. They experimented with adding a jump to the end of it, caused her to sit it down, but she was also going through a little bit of a sickness. They said they really needed to put it in a meet to see if she could do it. They have taken it out, and now she will just do a double Arabian, a half twist to a double front.
Wow.
And she nails it, no longer thinking about that jump.
But you get the big skill out of the way, the rest is cake, right? Maybe.
Most of the time.
Gotta have the stamina for the other two passes coming up.
There she goes. It really set her up when she nailed that first tumbling pass. Set her up to kind of set into place for the next two. Having a little fun there.
By the way, Scaglione pulled out a 9.775 in that leadoff spot ahead of her.
A nervous that he did want that leadoff to try to get those 9-8s, and she's right there chipping away at it. Just the last pass, taking that last breath. Really needs to set this up. Great positioning in the air. Was a little bit far. You could see she was close to the end of that mat.
But you had an idea she was aware of how close she was to that mat and made sure she stuck it cold.
I'm pretty sure she does set back a little bit and does have a longer double back. So she knows where to start in her run.
And there's Amanda Wellick. It was just beautiful on beam last week at Alabama. Looked really comfortable up there. Hit all her skills. Did a nice job with the dismount. Scored a career-high 9.9. She is looking to build here tonight.
It's amazing with how consistent she always is and has been. That was her first 9.9 on the balance beam, which definitely deserves.
She's had a great meet so far here tonight. More like that top all-arounder they'd expected her to be this season. Hasn't quite been able to put together four full rotations yet this season. Beautiful.
Looks so calm on the balance beam, really determined to hit this. There's been a few stumbles in front of her. Whether she knows that or not, she's definitely focused in. Side element again, the side sunny. Slight wobble, you can see her chest go a little bit forward. Just to dismount the round up again. A double full, slightly off to the side. You really want to make sure you're right behind that balance beam where you will get a deduction. And her side summit, you can see just a slight edge forward. It's very small, so it'll be a minimal deduction. Double full, definitely a harder dismount. And off to the side, but really needing to nail those beam routines.
MJ Rowe. This was a brand new routine for her last Friday. Handled it really well. She missed about 6 weeks after getting hit by a bike on campus. Really tweaking her knee there. Missed some significant training time because of it. Starting to hit her stride now.
Wow, that double layout is gorgeous. Really gets the height and the form. I just love watching her on the floor. Great leaps there. You could see her reach that full 180-degree split. Everyone is required to do a leap series connection. It's not just about the tumbling, but it's important to get those landings. She was earlier in the lineup last week, but because she was able to handle the new routine well, they have pushed her back this week, and it seemed to work well for her.
Well, they went back to her old routine in terms of that middle pass, so it was really all about muscle memory at that point, right? Sort of kind of go with what you know, and so far so good for her. She's having a great night in this meet. Scored very well on vault, looking to do the same on floor.
Nice double pike landing. Controlled. Could have gone a little bit higher. But I only say she could have gone higher because I saw her double layout. And I love it. Look at that height and her form. Great job.
Well, Colin Lawick before her had a 9.825, which is a season high for her. MJ Rowe looking for a big score there. Aaron Fryer. Now over on beam for Arkansas. She's missed only one rotation on beam in her entire career. She's looked so relaxed up there the last three meets. As relaxed as you can be, I guess, working on a beam that's 4 inches wide. She did not stick the dismount last week, but everything else was clean and crisp.
I really see the intensity in her eyes. Every time she does a movement, she has this intensity about her, and that's perfect for the balance beam.
And with her height, the long, lean lines. Beautiful.
Preparing here for her series, the back handspring layout. She nailed it. You really want to make sure before you prepare for a skill that you don't hold it or wait longer than 2 seconds. You can actually get a concentration pause. You really want to make sure you get up, get ready. Take your time, but you also need to make sure you keep moving through the beam routine. It's great the way she has been able to, if she's been a little off, hold it, the landing's longer.
Wow.
Finishing off with that dismount.
She is so pretty up there, and you see the continued aggressiveness by Arkansas on the beam.
It is from one athlete to the other. When they see someone else go up there and hit their routine, that is the best way to prepare the rest of your teammates behind you, is to be confident and aggressive, and she did it.
Amanda Willick before her had a 9.85. That should be another big score for the Hogs on the beam as we see Lexis Demers. She was a complete question mark this week in practice because she's a little dinged up, took a bad fall in the Kentucky meet a few weeks ago. And while she wasn't hurting bad enough to be kept out of the lineups last week, she was inserted really late into the week this week.
I think it shows she's a competitor. If she can do it, she wants to. She wants to be out on this floor. Very difficult first pass. Can be hard on those ankles if you land short, so she really needs to make sure she extends that takeoff position.
And Jeff Graber even said, hey, one more short landing for her and she's going to be done for a while, and we need her experience to go the distance this season.
Not just her experience, but when she performs and she is on, she can get those big scores. You can see that front pass was a little bit short. You want to really extend out that those front tumbling passes. I think it was smart how Coach Graba went about this. He wanted to make sure the kids who maybe haven't been in the lineups before, he wanted to make sure that they were prepared to go in. So he told them, look, you're competing.
Right.
And if she needs to go in, I'll tell her last minute. She's used to this.
It's easier to tell her last minute than it is a bunch of freshmen.
Last pass, great landing. Great choice to put her in.
You can't even tell at all that she's got any injuries whatsoever.
And that's just a sign of a great athlete when you can really put the pain behind and really push through for your floor routine. First pass, it's a full in pike. Two rotations in a pike position with that full twist in the air.
And Hugs, because the coaching staff knows she's a gamer. Sydney McGlone now over on beam for Arkansas. Casey has more on this freshman from Ohio.
Melissa, Mark Cook called Sydney McGlone inspiring this week. When we talked to him, he said it's so good to see her be aggressive at a young age. He said this team really feeds off of her and that the maturity level of her is something he hasn't seen. He loves seeing what she's done so far and is excited for her future in this program.
Well, we're fans. She has really improved week after week after week on beam.
And she knows it herself. She feels like she has set into her own little pace, her own system after that first meet, kind of getting out there, getting the jitters out of the way, really in the zone.
Scored a 9.75 on the road at Tuscaloosa. That was her high score of the season. And you just know those scores are just going to get better and better and better for her.
Really been aggressive so far on this entire beam routine. just to dismount the round off. Double full. Oh, a couple steps off the end there. You could see almost her foot maybe slip off the edge from that round off into the takeoff. So I'm glad she was able to bring it all the way around. A closer look. That foot just not completely on. I think it slid off a little bit. You can't tell too much. Causing those steps.
Kate Clues now for Auburn on floor. Her floor routine last week, and the Florida meet was her best yet this season, scored a 9.85. Jeff Graba wants her to adjust her landings, keep that chest up. She's got a lot of power, just got to control it.
Beautiful full in. She had a large step last week on that first pass. Was able to go into practice. They actually had two practices this week and fix it up. They had four meet within 12 days, only had one practice in between. So they feel like this is their first week to actually practice and get back to a meet and fix little issues that they've been having.
And that's a problem when you've got a lot of youngsters who are seeing time in the competitive lineups to not be able to get back into practice and fix the issues. And they've been able to do that this week, which is why Graba felt like they would be much better in this meet as opposed to the Florida meet on Friday last week.
It's difficult in itself to be a freshman, let alone have that many meets that heavy in the beginning of the season. But it's only going to help them as the season continues. Great routine so far. Just this last pass, double back. And she really did improve that chest up on the landing. What a fun routine, and she's excited. Had two very good passes before this. Finishes off with a double back, chest completely up, and you can see control within those feet.
Well, tonight at 10 Eastern on SEC ESPN Network, join our network analysts as they discuss all the SEC news of the day on SEC Now, streaming live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app. Samantha Nelson getting a little bit of a pep talk here before she goes up on beam.
Every athlete is different. They typically tell them pretty much the same thing before they get up on each event. What they all like is something different.
And talk about somebody stepping up to help your team out. She needed a 9.825 to beat Alabama on the road last Friday. So what'd she do? Picked the hogs up, put them on her back, and nailed her routine for a career-high 9.85.
Just like the rest of this Arkansas team, they really have improved each week, and that includes Samantha. Really has been aggressive with those skills. Great series, the back handspring layout step out. When you see someone nail every single skill, which means no movement afterward, they really show the judges there was nothing you could take on that. Great height on that punch front. You want to make sure your hips aren't too low, and they were definitely a good position.
Talking to herself.
She's got her key words to look at, and they really have been helping her. Just a slight hop on that dismount. It's a completely different team from earlier this season. The punch front, there it is again. See a great landing position. If they go too low with those hips down, there will be deduction.
Caitlin Atkinson will round things out on four for Auburn. Now, when they lost her at the end of last season to the foot injury, made a lot of changes to her routines this season. Her passes on four, her beam dismount, all designed to put less of an impact on her body. Because they're going to need her this entire season, and they need her to be able to go the distance.
It's so important. You can see she has the potential to get such high scores on every single event. They do need her, and she anchors those events. beautiful. And you can see, wow, great landing. And you can see that 4-inch mat there. They are allowed to have that. They just need the markers of the outline of the floor. But it's amazing with how good of a competitor she is and what scores she can bring them on each event. She gets frustrated with herself. She thinks she's not living up to her own expectations. She has very high standards for her gymnastics.
Well, she felt she hasn't put together a full 4 rotations yet this season. Maybe 2 good ones and 2 not so good ones.
But that's only going to help her as she continues to keep pushing herself. It will help push her teammates. Of a double pike. Great land. You can see her feet completely together. What a great floor mat lineup. Great routine, and then finishes off with her double pike, sets it way high in the air, and completes it with that solid landing.
Well, so far, Arkansas with a 49 on, over a 49 on every event here today, and standing by with Mark Cook, it's Casey Smith.
Coach, you said coming into this meet that you really wanted to focus on the smaller details and staying control of all 4 events. How do you assess it through 3 rotations?
Well, I feel we've been more aggressive this weekend as far as tonight on all of our events so far. Vault, we just only stuck really 1 vault, so we have to stick those vaults. Bars, we had some really good routines. We had some uncharacteristic mistakes, like Paige never misses a routine. And Stephanie had to kind of cover up a little bit, but Aaron did a phenomenal routine, came into being rock theme, so we're competing more aggressively now. We just have to calm down and just really eliminate all the little errors, but I'm very happy with our progress.
And looking at this last rotation, what do you want to see happen on floor to get this win?
Precision. They have to do each pass with a lot of precision, you know, on the landings, a lot of performance, a lot of smiles. She's got to, you know, sell the routines, be consistent, be strong, and, you know, we have to go after. We're really close. We're only like 2/10 out, so we have to go after it.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you so much.
He's down 0.3 to the Tigers heading into this 4th rotation and rallying the troops just before that interview.
Okay, 1 more battle. Let's go to floor. Let's perform. Let's entertain. Let's focus on good technique and be aggressive, okay? On three, gym back pride. 1, 2, 3,
gym back pride!
Let's go, you guys.
The Tigers extending their lead here to 0.3 heading into this 4th rotation by a score of 147-55 to Arkansas's 147-25. Auburn floor scores much better tonight.
That's right. They were hoping to really improve their floor, and that was in the landings, and they really did do that. Their chests were up. They had control when they finished their skills, and that was from the takeoff. They really did a great job.
Arkansas on beam, pretty good as well. You see the scores, a bunch of 9.8 pluses. The lowest score was a 9.725.
It's great. They have really been pushing their beam lineup to be better and better every week, and you can see they're so consistent as a team.
Now looking around the SEC, it's been a perfect week. Ashley Natt with a perfect 10 on her vault in the Kentucky meet last week, but oh no, we're not done there. We'll get to see her next week when we head down to Baton Rouge. But how about tonight? Florida, 3 perfect 10s. Alex McMurtry getting it done on bars.
This is incredible. 3 perfect 10s in 1 meet. McMurtry added that release move new this year, and I think with that landing, it really helped her get that 10.
How about Bridget Sloan? So you see the 10 there. Bridget Sloan added a 10. She got it on beam.
This crowd must be so excited and all over the place. This team has the potential to get this many 10s, but to actually do it, that's another story. Bridget Sloan could get him on every event.
And Kennedy Baker, money with that double piked Arabian on floor, hit that perfect 10 today. She's been looking for it for a while now, right?
She has. She has the capability to get a 10 every single time, but had slight errors here and there. So for her to do it this year, this early, is incredible for this Florida team.
Well, both those teams will be on the air, LSU and Florida, next week as part of our Friday Night Heights doubleheader. Florida, Georgia first, followed by the Hogs and Tigers down in Baton Rouge. When we come back, rotation number four, Alexis Demers, a beam slayer for the Tigers, looking to keep the trend going, while Arkansas freshman and breakout star Sydney McGlone prepares for her showstopper on floor. This is Coleman Lawick up on beam for the Tigers.
She has a different series that we've been seeing. It's back handspring to 2 feet. Backhandspring step out to a layout to 2 feet, excuse me. And this is harder, but the judges are really looking for those straight legs in the air.
And Jeff Raba says, you know, we don't put you in that leadoff spot to get a 9.95. We just need you to stay up there and be solid. She's new to beam, but did only 2 beam routines her freshman year. So not a lot of reps in the bag for her.
It's a new lineup position, but she does. She's nailing this routine. Great dismount. Just a slight step on the side. And that's what she needs to do. She needs to stay on the beam to really help her line up behind her. There we go. A kick over front. Right into that jump. You could see her feet almost completely off. It's amazing that she was able to hold on to it. Now that's what you want in the leadoff position, someone who can really fix an error in the middle and stay on.
And the reward from Coach Graba with a big hug as we see Sydney Dillard ready to lead off on floor for Arkansas. It's been great out of the gate in this leadoff spot. Really sets the tone nicely for the Hogs. First tumbling pass was a little off last week, but the rest of the routine was clean. Much better.
The front 1.5, and you can see her chest was up. Great landing. It always feels nice to hit that first tumbling pass to set your routine up.
We talked last week about them having issues with endurance when they were here against Oklahoma on floor. They had the 2 meets in 1 weekend. Had a lot of rest last week, got some rest this week. Should see no issues here tonight.
Another front twisting pass. You see the connection she adds that helps her with bringing that routine that starts at a 9.5 up to a 10.0. They need 5 tenths in bonus within their dance and their tumbling to have their routine start from a 10.0. Nice connection there and great landing. That will really help set your team up when you have a nice, clean routine that gets everyone ready to go.
I remember Arkansas down 0.3 to the Tigers heading into this fourth rotation, so they've got some ground to make up.
Every tenth will count for them here on out. That's why it's so important for them to make landings like that, completely nailed, with no movements, hopefully.
Back over to Beam and the Tigers. You see the score there for Colin Lawick, the 9.65. Not the best start on Beam for this Tiger team as we see Taylor Krippner, the freshman. Now she struggled on Beam last week, worked in a new leap series into her routine with just 1 day to practice. Jeff Graby said it was okay. And a fall. Still having some issues.
That's big. They have been talking a lot about this team is getting in their own heads. They're getting right in their own way. They really need to just relax and have fun. On Beam, obviously, you have to be a little bit more focused. It's a mental event. But they can drop 1 score from this Beam lineup. This will hopefully be that score, but the girls behind her now have the pressure to perform.
Raba says they have not performed on Beam in a meet the way they do in practice. He says in practice, Beam is actually their best event.
Just taking a little bit longer this season. Dismount, slight hop on the landing. It's unfortunate to have that fall. handspring layout step out. You could see her upper body was just completely to that left side of the beam. There was no way for her to cover it.
And I should mention, who's a really good team when the opposing team is falling on beam? That would be the Arkansas Razorbacks. Alabama had three falls on beam last week, and Arkansas took advantage. Happened a year ago as well, right here in Fayetteville. And now Stephanie Cannizzaro will try to deliver big for the Hogs here on floor. A lot of personality in this routine. Gets really high on that first pass and does an excellent job controlling her landings.
And they really seem to thrive when it gets close and down to that wire. They seem to start performing better than if they had a lead. Nice, clean double pipe there. Taking her time with that dance. A little bit of a built-in rest for her before the second pass. The double tap. You can see everyone jumping on the side. They know that's what she needed.
So Auburn was up 0.3 heading into this rotation. And now 0.1 is the lead for the Tigers.
Closing that gap. Some of the athletes don't like to know the score. They just like to go out and perform. But some athletes thrive under the pressure of knowing what they need to get. And that's Caitlin Atkinson, who will be last up on the balance beam. One and a half to front layout. Really performing this routine technically well.
She netted her best score of the year in Tuscaloosa last weekend with a 9-9. Looking for more of that here tonight.
Her first pass was the double pike. A nice clean landing. And is able to really finish her last pass as clean. And then this connection in the middle. Nice job.
See the fans in the stands here, willing this team to a victory. Send it over to Casey.
Well, Melissa, Jeff Graba told us this week that one of the things this team struggles with is self-imposed expectations, especially when something goes wrong. And after that fall on beam, he's telling his team down here, just focus. He wants these girls to really focus on themselves and what they can control, not what they can't, and just get up there and give their best in each routine.
Now, this is Emma Engler. And he said earlier this week, we have been absolutely horrible at building off the routine ahead of us. We've just got to continue to build and not put so much pressure on ourselves.
It's a great opportunity for Emma to restart the beam lineup. She's done a great job so far with all of her skills. Her only thing, she has changed. Oh, come on. Great fight there that she did not fall off. And now they're hoping to count this score, so she really needs to make sure, even with that large wobble that could be up to 3/10 of a deduction, that she finishes out clean. This is a new disc now. Instead of a round off, she's going to do it from a back handspring into that 1.5.
Ooh. Oh, my goodness.
She doesn't look like she got all the way around. Tweaked that knee. Oh, this is heartbreaking.
We saw the injury earlier in the meet to Miracle Phillips on vault. And now it looks like another injury here to the freshman, Engler.
And from that back handspring, just you could tell she didn't get quite the height she needed. Didn't get the takeoff off of there. Oh.
You really hate to see injuries in any sport, but for a team that's so young, trying to build some chemistry, they're trying to go out and give it their all.
And for this to be the second, that's got to be difficult for the rest of these athletes.
And now Arkansas will have to continue the meet over on floor. Leah McMoyle, the sophomore.
Great power in the air. You can see she was leaning just a tad forward to get her heels, the pressure back on her heels like she needed. But she's been a great addition to this floor lineup.
She can actually increase the difficulty to a double layoff that she tore her Achilles prior to coming to Arkansas. So won't do that quite yet. But this routine, we've seen it three times already, and it's very, very good.
And a great positioning as well on that middle pass. You can see one of the assistant coaches coming in the corner and standing there. And that was more for Leah to have a focus point, something to look at to make sure that that 1.5 connected into that front layout was right down the center of the diagonal. Just the last pass here to go. The double back. A nice solid landing. Arkansas is really finding those landings, but it's no wonder their Coach Cook has really a technician. He's able to really help fine-tune these athletes.
You see the staff helping to carry Emma Engler off. That was moments ago, who had the injury on beam. Now remember, Auburn had a fall on beam. Taylor Krippner, the freshman, will now have to count that score. It was a 9.325. Engler with a 9.075, so they will drop that score. Hopefully we can get some sort of update on her condition before we end this meet. But again, two critical injuries to Auburn in this meet. And right now, the lead, very, very slim for this Auburn Tigers team, who came into this fourth rotation up 0.3.
It's a tight lead, and having something that serious happen in the competition, you never want to see that. These athletes aren't really prepared for that. They don't want that happening. And now look, Lexis Demers is now up on the balance beam, having to really just finish off for this team. Nice connection there to that nice simple dismount. Great way to come back, and especially starting with this series, the backhand swing layout, she nailed it. She is definitely an athlete that can nail this beam routine. It could help bring the Auburn Tigers through the rest of this beam lineup.
Seniors are important for a reason. You got that leadership. Demers is a senior. You've got Atkinson, who will be the anchor on beam for Auburn. Samantha Nelson now on floor. Scored a season high, 9.9 last week in Tuscaloosa. Has so much fun with this routine. Also very good at controlling her landings. And you just feel that momentum shift to Arkansas.
You do, and it's helpful, though, that they're on the floor. The floor has a lot more energy. You can be on the side excited. Beam is a lot more of a mental event, we said earlier. A little calmer. You do like to cheer. But floor, you can really have fun with it, and that's what they're doing.
Arkansas is now up by more than a point in this fourth rotation. And looking to continue to build, while obviously Auburn is looking for some really key beam routines to wrap up this meet.
Nice little pass there. They are ahead now, but they do need to continue building off of what they have started. Arkansas has a long way to go for them as well. And they can't just sit back and let their lead happen. They need to keep improving.
You know what I like about this Arkansas team? Multiple times this year, late in meets, they've had to really show what they're made of, and they've done that. Coach Cook wants to be that top four team at SECs, wants to get this score tonight, wants to get the win tonight, and so far his team is delivering big yet again.
It's an exciting year for Arkansas. Was able to really find the landings on all three tumbling passes. Here's that middle connection pass, the 1.5 to front layout into a nice little pose.
So Arkansas so far on floor, everything 9.825 or better score-wise over on beam. Alexis Demers helping her team out with a 9.85. Now we go to sophomore Abby Millay. She had a slight body check in the floor to meet, saw her lowest score of the season. That's what she's coming off of, a 9.725.
She really wants to improve from last week. 9.25. It's not what she's capable of. She knows that. And she's looking to redeem herself here tonight. Great way to start off with that series, that handspring layout. Slight wobble on the full turn. You'll see every athlete do a full turn. They can hit their skills sometimes, and the wobble on the full turn, it's kind of one of those skills you wish you could get rid of. Staying as calm as she can right now, really trying to do one skill at a time. Into the dismount. Gainer full up the side.
Very impressive by the sophomore. With the pressure on her shoulders. And now she's got a senior that will finish up after her.
They are learning so much from competitions like this, where there is a fall, where they had a mistake. Sometimes you learn more from those mistakes and those meets that you don't do as well. And that's just going to help you for postseason.
And you hear the cheering from Hogs fans. Samantha Nelson with a career high 9.925 on four. Again, Arkansas just knocking it out of the park in this fourth and final rotation. They did it last week, doing it again here tonight. Sydney McGlone, the freshman, has a big, big skill coming up in this first pass.
She did it last week. It was depending on the warm-up with this week if she would do it again. We're looking to see if she does her double layout, the highest difficulty you will compete in college. And there it is. Got a little bit low into those knees and on the landing. Just needed a little bit more height in that air, but what an impressive pass.
And this is coming from a kid that, again, 2 weeks ago had some issues with the awareness, and now she's throwing out e-passes and making them look easy.
Great awareness of the twisting. Comes in on that landing, and she does. Great difficulty, the e-pass. Every skill is valued at a different amount of bonus or a different tenth. And so the E is the highest difficulty you will see the athletes compete in college. For a freshman, third meet of the season, but it's great to get those hard tumbling passes in the beginning so you can make sure to nail them at the end.
Here's her final pass, and you can see the confidence through the roof for this freshman.
Wow, what a routine.
Now that's how you do it on four.
They have been building and building, and she did have that slight knee bend in that first tumbling pass that would cause a slight deduction. She could have built great off of Samantha Nelson's 9.925, which is what you want to do. Great connection.
So if you put your judge hat on, she needed a 9.525 to win this meet. Did she get it?
She definitely got that.
Absolutely, she got it. Freshman winning the meet for Arkansas. Again, Auburn coming in with a 0.3 lead in this fourth and final rotation. Had a fall on beam. Had an injury to Emma Engler. Finished with a 9.075. And now Caitlin Atkinson will finish up on beam for the Tigers.
Great routine so far. She really does have the experience from having a senior class last year build her to be the senior this year. Hopefully she can start leading this team through her gymnastics.
So Arkansas with the win in the bag. Atkinson looking to finish strong.
Tuck 1.5. Large step to the side. She'll definitely want to fix that, the perfectionist that she is. But this was a tough meet for the Auburn Tigers, and to finish out with Caitlin on beam, it's a great way.
On floor for Arkansas, Amanda
Wellick will try to pull off a showstopper here on floor as the last gymnast up here in Fayetteville tonight. She gets up there on that opening pass. It gets sky high. No pressure for the junior whatsoever with a meet in the bag for the Hogs.
There is no pressure, but I don't think she ever feels the pressure. When she gets up on this floor, it's game time. Beautiful. She just really gets that height that helps her see the landing before she comes down. Fans getting into this floor routine with her. We said earlier, you really do want to have that artistry and performance in your floor routine. The judges are actually looking for that. It can give you a deduction if you don't have it. Came in a little bit short on that middle pass.
Mark Cook just wanted an all-around clean meet, put all four events together. Do you feel they're getting a little closer to that, Courtney?
They definitely are, and it's through their technique and how clean they are and finding those landings. They might not have the difficulty on floor like some of the other teams. Auburn, for instance, has a lot of E-passes, that difficult pass in their first selling pass. Arkansas has one, but yet they score so well because of that, because of the way they do their gymnastics. Great routine for Amanda.
Well, she needs a 9.825 for that routine to win the all-around. Did she get it?
She definitely got that. I would say at least a 9.9.
So once again, Arkansas down in a meet, come roaring back. No pressure for Amanda Wellick, but she delivers anyways.
She gets so high in her first pass for double pike and this last pass, the double tuck. Just, she could do another flip right there, I feel like.
Much improved routines this week. Much more aggressive, much more polished. Be proud of yourselves, all right? This is the moment. Great moment. We beat them, all right? Next up, Florida. Okay? Let's get back right. One, two, three, four.
Another great win for Mark Cook and his ladies. They do it here at home. Pulled off the victory last week. Coming from behind. They come from behind again today to pull off the win.
You guys are awesome, okay? Aggressive, mark our position, swing our routines one thing at a time, just precision, all right? Get in your zone. On three, GMX, go Bars. I got ahead of myself. One, two, three, go Bars! Go, guys. Come on. Come on, Seth. Go.
Good job. Good job. Just the end. That's it.
Looking good.
How'd the dance work out?
Pretty good.
Not bad.
That's okay. When you go for handstands, that happens once in a blue moon. That's all it does, okay? So don't worry about it. Okay.
Arkansas down 0.3 heading into the fourth rotation. Comes from behind to win this meet by a score of 196-6 to Auburn's 195-975. And I'm going to say it again this week, standing by with a winning head coach. Casey Smith is with Mark Cook.
Coach, you knew it would come down to that last rotation. You go into floor down, but this team finds a way to win again. What is it about this team that they can close meets?
Well, they met as a team after we had a little huddle going into that last event, and so they're all invested. I have five seniors, and they stepped up, and they told the girls, let's go for it. So, I mean, you have a leadership that helps a lot, and they're just dialed in this year. They're really close with each other. They've worked hard. They've really put the work in, and they're just having a lot of fun with their gymnastics.
It seems like a group effort from this team. Yeah. Who really stood out to you tonight?
Samantha Nelson had three outstanding events tonight. She was just an awesome on all three events. And I thought the Aaron Fryer was very aggressive on the two events that she was in. Amanda Willick dialed in on beam and vault. She stuck a solid vault. And it was just a really complete effort by the entire team. The girls are just really making their coach happy right now.
Well, that's a good thing. Thank you so much, Coach.
Thank you. I appreciate it so much.
So that man picks up his second win in back-to-back weeks. They beat Alabama. Alabama had the three falls on beam. Auburn struggled on beam as well. Opened the door for the gymbacks, and they kicked it wide open.
It's so sad to see when gymnasts get injured and are down from Auburn. We had two tonight. It's just a little bit gets to your heart. But Arkansas, they do take advantage, and they do step up to the plate now. It's a new team this year.
Well, they stepped up on beam. They stepped up on floor. And a look at our belt competing with style highlights tonight. It belongs to Amanda Wellick, our all-around title today.
She really did find all of her landings tonight on vault. Then on bars, it was a slight hop, but much better from the past couple weeks. She sat that just knocked down. And on beam, just nailed it for the Razorbacks. And on floor, she flies so high in all of her tumbling. But what's important is she finishes her landings.
And helped her team to the victory, a 196-6 to Auburn's 195-975. That is your final here from Fayetteville, Arkansas. Back-to-back wins and back-to-back meets for the Hogs. So for Courtney Kupetz-Carter and Casey Smith, I'm Alyssa Lee saying so long from Fayetteville. Now let's send it to SEC Now.